欢迎收看汉天生活报道，我是张潇。首先来看南加州社区方面的消息。洛杉矶比弗利山庄市会议与旅游局日前召开年度记者会。比弗利山市会议与旅游局总裁瓦格纳在会上向与会媒体记者介绍了将于1月17日、18日举行的欢乐中国年魅力京津冀演出事宜。中国驻洛杉矶总领馆文化领事王锦、比弗利山市会议与旅游局副总裁罗氏、中国市场开发经理刘卓以及活动赞助商代表皇家商业银行执行副总裁冯振发等来宾出席了当天的会议。请看报道。
洛杉矶比华利山庄市会议与旅游局日前召开年度记者会，比华利会议旅游局总裁瓦格纳在会上向与会媒体记者详细介绍了本次欢乐中国年魅力京津冀演出事宜。中国驻洛杉矶总领馆文化领事王锦、比华利会议旅游局副总裁罗树、中国市场开发经理刘卓以及活动赞助商代表皇家商业银行执行副总裁冯振发等多位来宾出席会议。
So this year marks Beverly Hills' 9th annual Spring Festival Chinese New Year event. It is our 5th year working with the People's Republic of China, the Consul General. We are very excited to present 2 shows this year. We have a VIP performance on Friday, January 17th, starting at 6 p.m. And then we have a performance that is open to the public on January 18th, starting at 3 p.m. Tickets are on sale through our website, lovebeverlyhills.com. And the shows both will be at the Saban Theater, which is located on Wilshire Boulevard in Beverly Hills.
那么今年也是第九年比弗利山市呢在当地举办春节的这个庆祝活动，那么这也是我们北京市第7次，还有呢就是后面加入的天津、河北第3次来跟比弗利山市共同来举办这个魅力京津冀的这个庆祝活动。这个活动啊，在四方的努力之下，可以说是已经成为一个红红火火的当地的一个品牌项目。每年的这个时节，当地的朋友们呢都已经对这个活动可以说是翘首以盼，所以跟往年一样，那么今年呢，我们也即将向我们的观众朋友们带来两场演出，一场呢是在17号的晚上，一场呢是在18号的下午。那么演出的内容呢，包括有民乐、有杂技、有舞蹈、有武术啊，都是非常的精彩。相信又是一个非常好的来自于中国的文化盛宴。我想这样的这个文化演出，对促进中美两国的文化交流以及增进两国人民之间的相互了解和友谊，都具有十分重要的意义。所以在此呢，也仅代表中国驻洛杉矶总领馆对活动的主办方表示热烈的祝贺，当然也要这个感谢这个比弗利山会议旅游局长期以来对促进中美人文交流所做出的努力。在此呢，也预祝今年的活动呢取得圆满成功，也要借此机会祝我们所有的朋友们在新的一年里身体健康、工作顺利、生活愉快、万事如意。
我代表皇家商业银行出席这今天的活动，皇家商业银行非常的荣幸能够有这次有机会能够和Beverly Hills 参加这个非常有意义的活动。在此祝贺大家身体健康，鼠年如意。
2020欢乐中国年魅力京津冀文艺演出将于1月17、18日两天在比华利山庄市萨班剧院正式演出，届时来自中国北京、天津、河北的艺术家们将为美国民众带来精彩的中国艺术表演，来自中国的演出团队将带来中国杂技、武术、民间舞蹈、京剧等中国民间艺术表演，让更多的美国民众领略博大精深的中华文化。主办方代表最后表示，欢迎南加各族裔民众届时光临本届2020年欢乐中国年魅力京津冀文艺演出，一起欢度中国新春佳节。汉天卫视记者吕立川，洛杉矶比华利山庄市采访报道。
说起往事只能回味这首歌，相信大家一定都不陌生。在鼠年即将到来之际，您可以在洛杉矶就能听到最原汁原味的往事只能回味。这首歌的原唱者，台湾玉女歌星第一人尤雅，即将携手最具魅力的香港影视男星刘恺威来到洛杉矶，在本周日1月19日下午5点，在阿瓜卡利安提赌场豪华剧院为大家带来精彩的《银花万簇迎金属》2020新春演唱会。请看报道。台湾玉女歌后尤雅携手香港知名男星刘恺威，将于2020年1月19日在阿瓜卡利安提赌场豪华剧院盛大开唱。尤雅唱红歌坛半世纪，迄今依然美丽如昔，歌声甜美动人。刘恺威更是中国最具魅力男星，出演的影视作品受到广大观众的喜爱，在综艺节目《跨界歌王》里更是展现出自己不俗的唱功。
我不要你的呵护，你的玫瑰，只要你好好久久爱我一遍，就算虚荣也好，贪心也好，那个男人对爱不自私不奢望。我不要你的承诺，不要你的永远，只要你真真切切爱我一遍，就算虚荣也好，贪心也好，最怕你把沉默当作对我的回答。
朋友们，新春吉祥，万事如意。我是尤雅，很高兴又要来洛杉矶和您见面了。这次演唱会和我同台的还有帅哥刘恺威。1月19号星期天下午，在洛杉矶近郊阿瓜卡利安提赌场度假村，尤雅刘恺威2020新春演唱会，你们绝对不能错过。
大家好，我是刘恺威，很开心，1月份呢回到LA跟大家见面，希望到时候能够见到你们。
原来你什么都不想要。
第92届奥斯卡奖提名于周一早些时候在洛杉矶揭晓。托德·菲利普斯拍摄的票房热门影片《小丑》以11项奥斯卡提名高居榜首。演员伊莎雷和约翰·乔布宣布了2019年上映的影片中的各项提名。《小丑》是9部获提名为最佳影片的电影之一，其他是《极速车王》、《爱尔兰人》、《少年乔乔的异想世界》、《小妇人》、《婚姻故事》、《1917》、好莱坞往事和寄生虫。最佳女主角的提名包括参演哈利特的辛西亚·埃里沃，参演婚姻故事的斯嘉丽·约翰逊，小妇人的圣罗南，爆炸新闻的查理兹·塞隆和朱迪的内勒泽·维尔格。最佳男主角提名包括参演痛苦与荣耀的安东尼奥·班德拉斯，好莱坞往事的莱昂纳多·迪卡普里奥，婚姻故事的亚当·德赖福，小丑的华金·菲尼克斯，两个教皇的乔纳森·普莱斯，爱尔兰人、1917、好莱坞往事各获10项提名。奥斯卡颁奖典礼将于2月9日在洛杉矶杜比剧院举行。美国广播公司电视网将再次直播这次颁奖典礼，这将是连续第二年没有人主持的典礼。去年颁奖典礼的收视率上升了 12%， 达到了2960万。
All right, we are back now with all the reactions to the Oscar nominations. We got some surprises, some snubs, some shockers maybe even. But the Joker got the most nods out of all of the films. Chris Connelly and Variety's Elizabeth Wagmeister back here to break it all down. We had some gas. We were watching you two kind of go at it every time an announcement was made. But for the both of you, what were the biggest shockers for you both? Start with
well, you go all Y chromosome on Best Director. I mean, I know there are like 8 Best Pictures nominated, and so somebody's going to be left out. But I do not understand why Greta Gerwig Gerwig is not in that category.
I do too.
I would have put her in instead of Todd Phillips for Joker, my son. Yeah,
absolutely. And you know, there's only been 5 women nominated in the Best Director category in Oscars history. Only one win, Kathryn Bigelow in 2010 for The Hurt Locker. Greta Gerwig was nominated for Lady Bird, but huge shock. And there's going to be some headlines, let me tell you.
Well, I was disappointed. I was really pulling for Adam Sandler. I thought that his role in Uncut Gems, I mean, that was
brilliant
acting.
Sandler's Sandler and J-Lo can throw a nice little party, and Beyonce can come by, too. I mean, there are a lot of really well-known people who might not have heard what they were hoping to hear this morning, but that's the way it goes. Best Actor was always a 10-car pileup. There are a lot of people to choose from, and all the nominees are outstanding. You can't deny that.
How about Scarlett Johansson?
So Scarlett Johansson, double nominee, supporting, and also Best Actress. Now, this has not happened since 2007. Cate Blanchett was a double nominee, but this is huge news for Scarlett Johansson because, as you said, Robin, her first nominations ever, and she got two right out of the gate.
And it's important because she'll have to have two written speeches ready to go, and Joaquin Phoenix won't have any. So that'll be good.
Back now with more Latin American Chris Connelly, Elizabeth Wagmeister from Variety. And Chris, you got a lot of movies here, at least three, where both actors are nominated. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, The Two Popes.
Yeah, The Two Popes is obviously in there. Perfect timing with The Two Popes having a little drama themselves Benedict objecting to the celibacy liberation, perhaps. And so a lot's going on there. Now, you've got two in the Best Supporting Actor category, right, with Joe Pesci.
Joe Pesci and
Al Pacino. Remember, Joe Pesci gave a 5-word acceptance speech when he won.
Isn't that right?
So maybe he'll have a little less to say if he doesn't win in this category.
Yeah. And Cynthia Erivo.
Yes.
In the Best Actress category.
This was absolutely a welcome surprise. People were definitely gunning for her, but this was a stacked category. Now, the good news is that means we're seeing some diversity in the acting nominations. We just saw at the BAFTA Awards, out of 20 nominations, they were all white actors. And Cynthia Erivo, she actually recently spoke to us at Variety, spoke out against that. So this is a real welcome surprise for her. She had told the BAFTAs that she won't perform because of the nominees, but there's still not a ton of diversity across the board.
And she's also nominated in Best Song, too.
Yeah, multi-talented.
Very much so. And so we might see her perform at the Oscars, too. Well,
Chris, can I ask you a quick question? Rocketman, do you feel like it was a little bit of the Bohemian Rhapsody factor?
I think maybe Rami after last year. I mean, I think everybody loved Rami. And of course, there's Renee Zellweger is your favorite for Judy Garland. Yeah. So it's not like you could say they object to people playing music. I think, again, it was just a jammed category, and he just lost out as a result.
He spoke about this at the Golden Globes, at Taron Egerton backstage. He said the movie came out so early that they have a tendency sometimes, that's like the death knell for some of these performances in movies. People forgot about it. They came out in May.
It's always tough when you're going up against a guy who's playing a pope. I'm just going to say.
But what about the little movie that could now? Parasite is really great. There. And it's picking up some steam. It has done so well, but they are very excited about their chances.
Yes, everybody is so excited about Parasite. Now, a foreign film has never won for Best Picture. It's nominated. A lot of critics think that it could win. Now, HBO, they also just optioned it for a series, so we might even see a Parasite series. So, yeah, that would be very cool. But I think when you look at Best Picture, you know, you're just talking about when these films are released very early, people forget about it. The opposite effect, what we're going to see is with 1917. That just came out. That's top of radar for the Academy, and I got a huge box office boost
number
this weekend,
one,
too. Number one.
Box office, $30 million for one shot.
Is Parasite competing against itself because it's going for both the best foreign film and the best picture?
You'd have to figure it's the likely winner for international film, you know. But the great thing about Parasite is it's a tribute to world cinema. You know, 20 years ago, they would have remade in Hollywood Parasite with two people from a sitcom in the lead. And instead, we're willing to enjoy the true version of Parasite. It's a phenomenal movie. It's going to get great attention.
So for both of you, what is the headline for you?
You know, I think the headline number one is female directors snubbed. I think another headline is J-Lo and Beyonce are snubbed. And then I think another headline, which we spoke about, yay for Cynthia Erivo, but again, not a ton of diversity across the board. It was just a few years ago we were talking about Oscars so white.
You know, and again, I think you have the two poles, the East and the West Coast. You've got Quentin Tarantino on the West Coast, Martin Scorsese on the East Coast. Those two movies did very well, as people would expect, and we'll see if they can do well on Oscar Day.
And we always ask you, any predictions?
Well, it's early, you know. I just hope they all show up.
Yes,
you
know? Yes, please do.
Well, the Best Actress category is really another killer. category three. Charlize Theron, Renee Zellweger, Saoirse Ronan, Scarlett Johansson, and Cynthia.
No, it's phenomenal. It's very strong. And again, people are saying that performance as Judy Garland really makes Renee Zellweger, who has a comeback story of her own to tell, that makes her the leader in that category. But these are competitive things. And Charlize was phenomenal in Bombshell. She's got every chance.
When she first walks on the screen, you say, that's my
God. Oh, my God.
It's
uncanny. She has a way of doing that. She metamorphoses into the character that she plays. It's such talent.
Not a surprise that movie also got a makeup nomination because of, you know, all the great things they did to make her look. Yeah.
It's going to be exciting.
It should be.
Action-packed, everybody. You can catch the 92nd annual Academy Awards right here on ABC. February 9th. And don't forget, on February 10th, we will still be up. We will be there with our GMAs, Oscars, after party. You don't want to miss it. That was fun. Thank you, Elizabeth. Amazing.
厄瓜多加拉巴格斯国家公园10日宣布，当年借调迪耶格等15海龟的保育计划已完成使命，各船种员将归建圣地亚哥动物园。来自埃斯帕尼奥拉岛，在美国服役超过30年，1976年被借调过来船种的迪耶哥，现在已100多岁，将被送返老家。保育计划1965年启动时，埃斯帕尼奥拉岛大海龟只剩下14只，其中12只是母的。1976年向圣地亚哥动物园借用的迪耶哥是当时仅存3只公龟之一。加拉巴格斯国家公园主管加瑞翁说，爱岛大海龟从15只繁衍到今天已达2000只。雪城纽约州立大学环境生物学教授吉普斯说，迪耶哥就贡献了其中的 40%， 功劳不可谓不大不过。另一头个性较保守、较不具魅力的公龟E5号产量更大，达 60%， E3号则一头子孙都没有。迪耶哥不是最多产的，为什么反而获得更多国际关注？吉普斯说，因为迪耶哥比较主动积极，交配习惯更有声有色，因此吸引媒体的目光。相形之下，更多产、更安静的E5喜欢夜晚活动，难怪发人注意。海龟传种取决于母龟选择哪只公龟。吉普斯说，说来会让你吃惊，海龟也有类似人类的男女关系，不过他们的社会结构和配偶关系详情很少人知道。加瑞翁的解释更直接，迪耶哥具备令他特别的特性。根据加瑞翁的研究，伸展可达5尺、重176磅的迪耶哥1930年代就被从出生地抓走。大海龟保育计划主持人塔皮亚说，目前海龟总数以及富裕环境已够正常传宗接代，不用再借调年轻海龟迪耶哥离开家乡80年后。经美国动物园生涯和厄瓜多拯救种族任务，3月终于可以回到埃斯帕尼奥拉岛故乡养老。
Diego, he don't give a shit. Diego keep fucking like he don't mean nothing. He saved his people with his dick. Diego, he just turned 100. And how does he do it? I'm wondering. They say he's good looking and you can't deny it. Diego's the king, is redundant. He's got unstoppable libido. He's fucking more than we do. They flew him in from San Diego to eternal booty like a cheetah. Who makes the ladies finish quick? Diego. Who saved the species with his dick? Who do we call the king of Espanola? We're looking no further, baby. This is it. His name is Diego.
Diego.
Playboy.
He's the court star.
科学家最近找到地球上最古老的物质，即拥有约70亿年历史的星辰，隐藏在一块半世纪前来到地球上的巨大陨石中。这些星辰由太阳系形成前产生的太阳前颗粒组成，是由星球在死亡前的生命最后阶段排放至宇宙中。部分星辰是跟随一颗小行星生成的重达220磅的巨大陨石，于1969年9月28日坠落在澳洲维多利亚省和穆奇生镇附近。研究人员在新研究中报告称，他们分析数十颗太阳前颗粒后，发现它们的历史不尽相同，从太阳生前约400万年到30亿年不等，而太阳是46亿年前生成，而这些星辰中约 60% 都拥有46亿到49亿年的历史。研究结果于13日刊登在国家科学院报。由于太空中的颗粒不断遭受宇宙射线的高能粒子撞击，这些宇宙射线会和岩石交互作用，生成新元素。科学家测量颗粒内部的元素含量，就能估计年代。研究人员称，这项发现支持许多天文学家的说法，指出约70亿年前星球生成的数量曾一度暴增，而且许多颗粒都是集体活动。芝加哥菲尔德自然史博物馆普利兹克陨石与极地研究副馆长赫克说，这些颗粒为何连接成群尚不清楚，但有研究显示，有些颗粒表面有一层有机物质黏膜，可能因此黏在一起。多数的太阳前颗粒长度都在一微米或更小，但科学家在本次研究中分析的颗粒尺寸都更大，长度在20到30微米之间。尽管宇宙中充满漂浮的尘埃，地球上的岩石中却从未发现过太阳前颗粒的存在。赫克说，这是因为地球生成时收集到的太阳前颗粒，在地壳变动等星球活动过程中都被加热并转化。史上第一位获得金球奖最佳女主角的华裔女演员林嘉珍，尽管并未获得奥斯卡提名，但她22日即将在有线电视频道喜剧中心首播的全新影集《Aquafina is Nora from Queens》已确定拿到第二季续约。 喜剧中心有线电视频道14日宣布，林嘉珍主演、编剧和执行制作的全新影集《Awkwafina is Nora from Queens》22日首播。这部描述林嘉珍在纽约皇后区成长的真实故事已续约开拍第二季。中韩裔女演员林嘉珍本名是 Nora Lam， 她因为主演电影《别告诉她》获得本届金球奖音乐喜剧类最佳女主角，成为史上首位获得金球奖最佳女主角的华裔女演员。尽管13日并没有被奥斯卡金像奖青睐获得提名，林嘉珍仍然表示感激。她表示，我对这趟旅程中发生的一切感到感激，我的旅程很精彩，透过这个节目和电影，我们已经在今年看到了表现，我为自己能做自己正在做的事万分感恩，即使只被认可到一丁点都是不可思议的事。林嘉珍创作的半小时电视剧《Awkwafina is Nora from Queens》是与黄荣亮、杨博文和洛瑞·坦奇恩共同演出。林嘉珍的父亲是华裔，母亲是韩裔，四岁丧母的她自幼由祖母照顾，深受其深远影响。她14日表示：“我喜欢和奶奶在一起，食物真好吃。”林嘉珍在青少年时，因为强烈感受到外向却又被动的自我性格，想象出了 Awkwafina 这个怪名字。谈及这部戏，他说：“我想借此描绘我成长过程中非常真实的观点。Nora 的性格描绘一点也不夸张，她一点也不需要去做不符合她真正自我的事。我希望她能鼓励年轻孩子们不要害怕做自己。”
Hey Nora,
man, your parents got you on Trashity too.
Aren't you like 27?
You need help buying liquor?
No.
Oh. What happened? I live with my parents.
Grandma loves Nora.
I wish I had purpose like you, you dumb.
Hey, boy. We need to find you a job.
Pull over now, or I'm calling the cops.
Surprise, but have a good one. Room is like...
oh! Oh my god, I gotta get out of here.
I need my social security number. Do you have it?
You don't know your own social security number?
A lot of people don't know their social security numbers.
And if I can make it work, anyone can make it work.
I would love to cash this check here.
Crispy bills, none of that wrinkly that you pull out of your ass.
Pleasure doing business with you.
You're not supposed to kill the villagers, they're peaceful people.
I love killing. Die, mother.
以上就是今天的汉田生活报道，我们下期再见。